Hello and welcome back. Here is a question by one of our website visitors, Ravi. He writes, I have watched your videos on YouTube and visited your website. All the information is so helpful. My issue is that I am trying to make a user form in which I have three list boxes or text boxes. I want that when I select the value from first list box, it shows the values associated with it in Excel sheet in list box 2. Example, in list box 1, TV, computer, camera. When I select TV, it shows me different brand names of TV, which I have already written in one of the columns in Excel sheet. Example, TV, Sony, LG, Panasonic, etc. And after that, when I select Sony under TV, then it shows some information about Sony, which is also written in Excel sheet under some category name. So basically, I have three steps. One, load data in list box 1. Step 2, load data in list box 2, depending on list box 1. Step 3, load data in list box 3, depending on what I choose in list box 2. Thanks in advance for your help. This is indeed very interesting and very useful in practical daily life. So let's see how we can solve this problem quickly using Excel VBA. So based on the user inputs, I have created here an Excel worksheet with a sheet called items where I have TV, computer, camera. In suppliers, I have under TV, Sony, LG, Panasonic, and under computers, I have HP, Dell, Samsung, and under cameras, I have the different suppliers. Then in the details, I have entered, for example, for Sony, the different LCD TVs and the respective prices. A similar thing I have done for computers and for the camera, but for HP and Canon. For Sony and Nikon, for example, I have just said not in stock. Okay. Prices not available. Now, the second thing that I have done is I have named these ranges. For example, this is items. In suppliers, this is, for example, suppliers. In computers, I have this as computers. And under cameras, I have cameras, okay. In details, sizes, then the name, there's no name for this, okay, because we are going to use a text box to get the individual prices. So now let us have a look at the VBA code. Let's go to Developer, Visual Basic. And here is the form that I have created using standard methods. For example, I've clicked on label and created a label, select an item. Here is a list box 1, for example. This is a list box 1. Then I have the list box 2 with the corresponding label, list box 3. And here is a text box that will display the price. Now, before I show you the code, let us see this form in action. Okay, so I'm going to run this form. And you see, you get something like this. So what I have done is, when I activate the form or I initialize it, you can see the various items. So if I click on TV, for example, you immediately get displayed here. Sony, LG, and Panasonic, which is also indicated here. Select a company from displayed companies. Now, if I click on Sony, if you remember, I have these items, so they display. Now, if I click on, let us say, 22 inches LCD, I get this price. If I click on this, I get the corresponding price, and so on. When I clear this, it only clears the price. If I select computer, then I get these computers. Now it is displaying the older data, but let me click on HP, and there you see you have the Intel 3. You can see here i3, i5, i7. So if you select i3, I haven't put any prices here, so you won't see any prices. All right, let us take the camera. So Canon, you get ABC. There are no prices here. If you take Sony, not in stock. All right, so this is how it works. And now I'm going to close this, and it ends the sub. Now let us see how this has been coded. So if you double click on this, you see here, if listbox1.listindex0, that is the first item, similarly 1 and 2 for the second and third item, it should take the row source suppliers. All right, this is the listbox1. But let me start with the form when I activate it. So there it is, user form activate, then textbox1 set focus, it sets the focus in the text box. Then the listbox1 gets populated with the items. All right, and then our work starts. So we select in list box something. So if you select 0, you will get the suppliers. If you select 1, you'll get the computers, and so on. The interesting thing is now here in the list box 2, because based on what you select in list box 1 and list box 2, you're going to get certain data in list box 3, isn't it? So first of all, we say if listbox 1 has 0 and listbox 2 also has 0, then display, for example, sizes. Similarly here, if listbox index 0 and listbox 2 is 1, then you display the sizes, and so on. All right, this is for the TV. Now if we go further, here we have for the computers. Do you see that? I have done only for the TV and computers, as you can see. The other ones you should try. We do a VLOOKUP. Only if this is true, then we put in the text value. Using the application VLOOKUP, we look into our list box 3 and look in the data sheets details, the range AB, and we select the column 2, and we want to find the exact price. Alright, this I have also discussed in other videos. You can have a look. I'm going to place all this code on my website so you can study it carefully and use it. But I haven't done this completely. Now to do it completely, you will also have to work a little bit, and that would be an exercise for you. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.